And we have some beautiful roses with
we
us.
We do. And they smell amazing, too. My goodness.
I wish it was smell-o-vision.
Smell-o-vision.
James Stevens is here with us from Roses Only. And you'll see some roses adorning the Five Live studio coming up. So we wanted to tell you who is behind it. And you have such a great story about your love of the flower. It's not just about a delivery for, I messed up with the wife, dig some roses. No. You have a passion for this flower we're holding. So tell us about Roses Only.
Welcome to the show.
Yes,
thank you.
Welcome to Five Live.
Thanks very much. Roses Only, just by way of background, I've probably been in the industry for about 50 years. Only because...
So were you born in a flower shop? How do you have 50 years experience?
I used to attend flower markets with my late father, and that was basically what I did. And we would walk around the markets looking for the finest quality flowers that we could possibly buy to take back to our flower shop, as in the family flower shop. And
it's grown a little bit since the family flower shop.
It has, and I recognized that the one flower, the only flower that men pretty much knew the name of when they walked into a flower shop was the word rose or roses.
Right.
And if you typically ask any man to name more than three, I think they'd struggle.
Yeah. But
yeah, because I know Rose. I know Rose, and I know more roses. That's what did I do it right?
You got
You know Roses Only.
Yeah. There you go. Exactly.
Right. So
always working that brand. That was perfect. Yeah.
And look, we would get I noticed over many years individuals coming in for a very very special occasion, being an anniversary. You'd only see men coming into your store two or three times a year. Unfortunately, yes, when they are in trouble.
Yikes.
Maybe drank just that little bit too much at lunchtime.
Lunchtime.
Well, yeah, that's an Australian thing.
I was going to say, leave it to the Australians at lunchtime.
That's right, that they've clocked off.
Yeah.
But anniversaries in particular, anniversaries and birthdays, but anniversary in particular, it's like it's my anniversary and I want a dozen of the finest roses.
Mm.
And typically that's a long stem rose. They know what they're looking for. And really, all we did was I decided back in circa 1994 to start a company that just honed in on the finest long stem roses that you could possibly buy anywhere in the world, packed in some simple packaging.
Right, eco-friendly.
Yeah, eco-friendly.
But still beautiful. Still beautiful.
Yeah, and then it's about, you know, we partnered in places like Australia and the United Kingdom and Singapore and Hong Kong. We partnered with beautiful champagne houses like Dom Perignon and Veuve Clicquot and Moët de Chandon. Then fine chocolate house such as Godiva Chocolate. Right. So we are doing Godiva Chocolate here in the US along with the finest roses.
And what's so important to know is that in only two places right now, expanding soon, but in only two places right now, New York and LA, you can order roses by 1 o'clock in the afternoon and still get them the same day. And that's what we want to emphasize here on Five Live, because we were greeted to a box of these and we Instagrammed them. We used the hashtag KTLA5Live because we thought we had a fan, and we did. Yeah. Roses Only sent us the same day that we launched Five Live. They sent us some roses, and that's why we're so excited to show the box. You say, let's start opening. Let's do one of these. Let's each do one. How about
okay,
that?
Cool.
We call it the unveil.
The unveil. And you say unveil. This is the Tiffany box of flowers.
Yeah,
so why is that?
Well, it's about the finest being packaged beautifully, the attention to detail.
If somebody walks in and hands you this, you're going to be very impressed, right?
Well, that's right. Definitely.
Oh my gosh. Very cute that is.
Wow. So if somebody were to order from you, this is how it would look. This is how they would come in. Beautiful, beautiful. This is a little morbid, but it's like a little casket for your roses.
Ooh.
Beautifully, beautifully.
I mean, they look so pretty, you almost don't want to take them out. Can you see this? Sorry.
Every single rose has got a beautiful, it's individual water pouch.
Oh, sure. Let's pluck one out.
Yeah, let me show you guys that. Here we are.
Same day roses, roses only. And why do you have such a passion for the rose? Well, you said it started in the flower shop, but
it's a classic gift.
The science behind it. Well, cut diagonally, trim the leaf. How did you get into this?
Well, the family were in flowers, and cutting a flower such as a rose or any woody fibered flower should be cut on an angle to increase the surface area that it can drink from.
Okay, I've always wondered.
There's a bit of science there. The other piece is that this is the only flower that has transcended, generations, because you've always bought a classic 12 roses as a romantic gesture.
Right.
For those that are really romantic, they go two dozen. I must say, I've said in the past that I'm not very, very impressed with men that buy six.
Because the single
I think is a very romantic gesture.
Okay, what, it is what a romantic does that gesture. Mean, then?
Yeah, so
well, one rose.
The one rose is the one love. It's maybe it's a declaration of love. It's your initial declaration of love.
A la The Bachelor, right? Isn't that why they did the rose, one single rose?
Yeah, possibly.
But there's many.
Yeah.
But then
I think when you know that it's a fait accompli, that the relationship is solid, you have to go the dozen.
So one or a dozen, no six.
Yeah, I think six is like going to a bar and asking someone, would you like to have half a drink?
So I have a question for you. I've heard a lot about the different colors and that they mean certain things, like white is the sympathy, or that red is obviously love, yellow friendship. Is that something that people kind of inquire to you all the time about? Is that something
if you do some research, you'll find that depending on which organization you're reading, you'll get a different color meaning for every rose. And I've seen different color meanings for yellow. Pink could be friendship.
You have light pink, hot pink.
Yeah. So is it hot love? I mean, but red definitely is. And we don't even bother doing any other color on Valentine's Day. We only do red. It is pointless.
Forcing the passion.
Yes. Well, that is the it's the quintessential color. If you think of anything that's got some sort of Valentine's Day merchandising or anything to do with Valentine's Day, it's red.
It's red.
So let's not waste our time with anything else. Of course, throughout the year, typically, men would send red or pink or white if they know their partner's favorite color. That would determine, obviously what you receive. But then, over time you can obviously alter but
have
I think
fun
red
with the
is
colors.
The,
so what's oh, oh go ahead, Alexandra. Yeah,
I was just going to ask you, what separates you then from the rest of the companies that have?
Yeah, it is that attention to detail. We would have picked every single one of these roses. We would have discarded roses that others would not discard, and they would actually go to the trouble of, well, they wouldn't go to the trouble. We go to the trouble of looking at every single rose, checking the petals, checking that there aren't any creases in the petals, no wrinkles. Wrinkles could imply that, the rose is actually old. So we want to give you the freshest possible longest rose that's going to last. When freshest means obviously that the longevity is going to be there as well.
Who's doing this? Are you doing it? Are you the guy? Are you in there?
Are you individually
checking them? What's that process like?
Beautiful.
Yeah, look, we've got some amazing people, some very, very talented people. Ecuador or Colombia, anything that's, these are grown at elevation, typically above 7,000 feet above sea level.
Oh, wow.
In countries like Ecuador or Colombia or Kenya or Ethiopia. If you think about the equator and what countries at elevation, they're typically those countries.
I can't get over the ones that are in the back of this box. Look at how long the stem is.
Yeah, so you've got to look for beautiful foliage, lovely green foliage, a lovely big head. This is not a puny little head.
No, it's not.
The thickness of the stem is really, really important. And there's enough there for you to keep cutting away and keeping it fresh. Because the idea, in a perfect world, you should be cutting your rose every day.
Okay.
You should be cutting the rose and fresh water in a vase. And I'm not just saying, don't just tip it out and place new water, actually clean the vase with a little bit of bleach or something like that, because bacteria builds up in the in the actual vase itself.
That's the one thing I wanted to know before you left us today was how to make sure your we're going to have some in the studio, so we want to make sure they look good for the rest of the week once we get them. So and clean the vase.
Clean the vase. The biggest thing is fresh water daily.
Fresh water.
A little chop of the rose to create a new surface for it to drink from.
All right,
clean surface.
Before we go, here's my question to the Rose Master General. What is the most romantic or kind of over-the-top thing you've seen with someone doing flowers as far as the roses? Have you gotten a call that said, I need 200 roses at this time, at this place, for this thing? Do you have that story that you think of often?
Yeah, look, the most typical one is your dozen, but we have had a 5,000 roses order.
Was it Kanye?
Was it Kim and Kanye?
No, it was someone that quite obscure that was really wanting to impress. And and that was probably carried by about 10 guys.
Wow.
It was so heavy. I mean, it's a very, you think about the sum total. I mean, you're carrying about 30 roses there, or 36 roses, in fact.
5,000.
So think about 5,000.
Wow.
So, and another thing is
just to give people an idea of how tall and beautiful these stems are. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Look at this.
So there are, depending on the culture as well, like the Chinese have got some famous songs.
About roses.
About roses and about love. And the song is 999.
Oh, well,
means a hell of a lot of love.
Yes.
But yeah, so we, you know, I suppose that would be the one that stands out.
So that's an example of the beautiful roses and quality. And we'll be posting this on our Instagrams. Thank you so much for coming in, James. This is such a treat to get a box. And here in LA and New York right now, expanding to other cities soon, you can get same day delivery on beautiful roses only. So roses only US, that's right now where you can find them on Instagram if you want some examples.
Rosesonly.com.
Rosesonly.com, the at rosesonlyus. And Scott, show them the nice big box you'd get if you...
You get this big box.
You cuddle your roses.
He's still cuddling his roses.
I've got lots of roses. You get this little, this big box here, covered in.
How does that not impress?
Yeah, and then this beautiful box underneath.
Guys, I think I'm just going to stay like this for the rest of the show.
I think that's your new profile pic.
Yeah, right?
I like it.
It was so great to have you.
Thank you so much for being here. And you can find them again, rosesonly.com. And you can find more information when you watch this again.
Or on our website.
KTLA.com.
That's
about that?